Come on, man. We're not 1 and 2. Let's go out here and play this thing, all right?
Let's be ready to run now.
I like that. Boys.
What time is it?
Game time! Boom!
What's good, y'all? Welcome to another episode of Game Time. My name's Mike, here as usual with Jeff and Dave. We got our second football player to join us on the show for this episode, Selena Fernan from Ateneo. Selena, we're glad to have you on the show. Thanks for joining us.
No, thank you, guys. Well, I'll thank Jeff for actually messaging me personally on Instagram. So shout out to Jeff.
Shout out to Jeff. That's what's up.
Yeah.
All right, cool. So we're going to get to know you a lot better in the next hour or so. But first things first, how are you going? How have you been holding up over the past 6-something, 7 months, whatever?
I've lost count now.
What's good? What's good with you?
Well, I was in Manila like a few months ago, but then when the lockdown happened, I had to fly back to Cebu. And so when this whole COVID happened, we still actually had online training every day, which was actually insane, but it was also like kind of good just to stay fit. So I think relatively it was just coping with a whole new normal. Yeah.
So you mentioned that you had this online training activities. How often were you guys doing that?
Well, actually, like a few months ago, we kept doing every day. But then since classes started, we would only do like MWF.
Mm-hmm.
So they shortened the term of training.
All right. Now, we know you because you play football for the Ateneo. And we're going to get to, like I said, we're going to get to know you a bit more during the show. But for our listeners who may not be familiar with who you are, can you tell us a little bit, just a quick intro on who you are? Tell us a little bit about who Selena Fernan is.
Okay, so hi guys, I'm Selena Fernan. I'm from Cebu City. I got recruited in the Ateneo de Manila University. I'm in my 4th year now and I'm taking psychology. And yeah, I'm just really glad to meet you guys. I honestly hope that I can see you personally, but you know, since we're doing this whole online Zoom, but next time we'll see each other definitely.
For sure, we'll make that happen. Okay, we're gonna talk about football in a bit, but before we get to that, outside football, what else are you into? What else do you get up to?
Well, lately, I've been just hanging out with friends, you know, just reminiscing about the past. And I actually do motocross as well. So I ride motorbikes that are manual, specifically 250cc. I don't know if you understand that term. So yeah, we go trailing. I don't know, I'm just kind of adventurous.
Right. What got you into motocross in the first place?
Well, I started when I was really young. I think I was like 8 years old. So yeah, my dad actually taught me how to ride a motorbike. So that's where it all started.
Right. Do you ride a motorbike regularly, like outside of motocross? Do you own your own bike?
Yeah, I actually do own my own bike and I used to race back then, but then I stopped because I wanted to pursue football. I think it just runs in our family. Like, I also have a cousin. His name is Matteo Guidicelli. He's also a go. He does go kart. So I think it just really runs in the family how we just love sports and racing in general.
Right. So where do you usually how often do you still get to do it often these days? Motocross with the lockdowns and all that. Are you allowed to do it or?
No, we actually can't do it. So I'm just stuck at home doing football drills.
Right. And with how about before all the lockdowns and everything happened, how often were you doing your motocross riding?
Well, when I moved to Manila, I completely stopped because I just wanted to focus on football and studies. So everything stopped. So I just really focus on football and trying to get better every day.
Yeah, hopefully you get back into it at some point. Jeff, I'll give it to you for our next section of the show.
All right. Selena, our next section in the show is about quick hits. So this segment is about, I'm going to say words, names, phrases, or anything. So you just say to me the first word that comes up into your mind. So
okay. Anything random.
Anything random, yeah, it's very random, and you say it quickly. So, first word or phrase. you want to describe about it.
The word or phrase, sige.
Yes. All right. Oh, by the way, what's your number again? As a player, what was the jersey 17. Number? 17. We have 17 questions for you in here.
Oh my God.
All right, let's start. Okay, the first one, Ateneo.
The best.
Motocross.
Challenging.
Moira Lim.
Goalkeeper.
Bellarmine Field.
Far.
Messi.
Goat.
Rizal Memorial Stadium.
Big.
Passion.
Passion?
Yeah, passion.
Football.
Ronaldo.
Beast.
Philosophy.
Father David. That's my teacher, sorry.
How is he as your teacher?
Do you guys know him, Father David?
He wasn't my PLO teacher, so I don't know.
Okay.
So.
Okay.
It's all right. Okay, Yana Bautista.
Angel.
Cebu.
Love.
Beach.
Tan.
Workout.
Fit.
Playing soccer in the rain.
Thirsty Cup. That's a football league that we played before.
Jill Panganiban.
Captain. She's amazing. She's really amazing.
All right. Katipunan.
Traffic.
All right. Do you miss the traffic? No.
No.
All right. That's it. So it's just easy, right? So
yeah.
The next portion that we have is X's or O's. So I'll say two words. You pick one which you prefer better between the two.
Okay.
All right. Okay. All right, let's start. Offense or defense?
Offense.
All right. Coffee or tea?
Tea.
Thin or thick?
Thin.
Written or oral?
Written.
Play or study?
Play.
Tequila or teka muna?
Tequila for sure.
What's your favorite tequila?
Secret lang.
Sleep in or workout?
Workout.
Messi or Ronaldo?
Ronaldo.
Palaban or relax lang?
Palaban.
Manila or Cebu?
Manila.
Okay. All right. My last segment here is about fill in the lane. So I'm gonna say words here. I mean a sentence here. You complete it. So it's like a fill in the blanks at the end.
Oh wow! Okay.
Okay. All right. I'm the happiest when I am blank.
Working out.
After this pandemic, I want to travel to blank.
Bali.
Have you been there before?
Yes, when I was like 3 years old.
Wow. Blank always gets me excited.
Football.
I am at my most intense self when I blank.
When I play as defense.
But you prefer offense, right? Or
yeah, but sometimes the coach puts me in defense.
I would describe myself as blank.
Strong.
All right. Awesome. Thank you very much, there, Selena. That's it for my part here in Fill in the Lane. Back to you, Mike.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks for that, Jeff. Selena, we want to get into a little bit about your interest in football. Can you tell us how you got started in the sport?
Okay. So I started when I was around 9 years old. My best friends taught me about it. And in the beginning, I wasn't that great. And so I think every day I kept training and training. And eventually, I had the passion, the motivation. And then from Giuseppe Club, I went to Ateneo de Cebu. And that's where I got recruited by Ateneo de Manila. And so now I play for Ateneo de Manila. And it's been really great, honestly. Like, of course, there are ups and downs naman. But then you just have to keep going and going since this is like the passion that I love. and I get to meet different people in Manila. And yeah, just from that, it's been such a great experience, opportunity, and blessing.
Mm. You mentioned that you got introduced to the sport by your friends. How yes. about within your family? Do you come from a sporting family? Do you have a sporting background, like your parents, your, I don't know, cousins or whatever? Like, did any one of them play football as well?
Yes, they played football, but I think it was just more of like for fun. Like, I think they've tried it out like once or twice, but I was really the one that pursued it. And yeah, honestly, this whole college experience have been very supportive, and they've been reposting my pictures in Ateneo and just stuff like that, like telling me, hey, I'm so proud of you. And I'm like, okay, thanks.
Dave, you have
a
question.
I see that, Dave. I see that.
Yeah, I'm just curious to find out, Selena. You mentioned that you were, as Mike said, you were introduced to the sport via friends.
Yeah.
But at what point did you, I guess, decide that I'm getting pretty good at this? I want to pour more resources into it. I guess at what age or at what stage in your life did you say I'm kind of good at this, and this is something I want to put some more time into?
I think when I hit high school, I think we have this coach, her name is Coach Apple. She would always tell me to be, you know, just be confident, just keep doing the same thing that you're doing. And with that, she really taught us the basics, because the basics are very important. So she taught us everything from level 1 to like level 50. And so every day we keep training and training and training. And since I had like a good support system, like with my friends and teammates, they'd keep pushing me, and we'd push each other naman. And I think that's just how like it went.
Right. What was it about football though that drew you into it? Like you mentioned that you learned it when you were 9 years old, and I assume that at some point there it was like, yeah, this is what I want to do, right? You just mentioned it. But what was it about football that you really liked and got your attention as a kid and made you who you are today?
I think every morning when I would wake up, the first thing I would think about is like football. And I think we keep hearing this from like athletes. Mm. When we sleep, we think about the sports and a certain thing we love. And sometimes a lot of people don't understand that. They don't understand that motivation, that grit, that passion. And so sometimes it's kind of hard for you to explain to people that don't really understand that.
Yep.
So I think what I had to do was, I didn't really do the talk so much. What I did was I placed actions to what I was, to what I love. And so people then finally realized like, yeah, she loves this sport. And I think just from there, I just always had like the discipline in trying to learn from others, from my coaches. And if I needed help, I'd really ask my coach, like, hey, I need help with this. Like, I'm bad at this. Please help me. And so, you know, the coaches are also so open, like, oh, okay, she really actually wants to learn. And, you know, there are some times where even if you make a mistake, you still, you know, keep going at it, because, you know, that's life. That's the beauty of life. Mm-hmm. We fail, but we go up. When you keep looking down, the only thing is to look up, diba?
Yep. Yep.
Wow, that was so inspirational.
That's dope.
Man, Selena is inspiring. Maybe we can get her as a life coach or something.
For sure, guys. I'd be the best, promise. You can chat with me on Instagram.
So I imagine, like, how quickly did you pick up the sport? Like, how quickly did you become good at it?
Oh my gosh, how good at it. Let's be humble naman. Maybe like when I hit second year of high school, so it probably took me like 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
4 years, yeah, 3 years. So just every day of like practice and routine and the same drills and, you know, stuff like that.
Yeah, it's that persistence and that consistency,
yeah.
Right? In the work that you put in. But over the course of, you know, you getting to know the sport and you becoming better, were there any athletes or were there any football players that you looked up to and kind of like watch and pattern your game after and try to model your game or your training routines after during that time?
Well, I think the only like role model that I've ever looked up to was Cristiano Ronaldo. He's a left footer, and I'm also a left footer. And so since he's a left midfielder, I'm also a left midfielder. So like I watch his videos quite a lot, and I just try to like replicate his tricks, his techniques, his skills, and just stuff like that.
Yeah, that's not a bad place to start, I guess, modeling your team after. That's a 5-time player of the year winner soccer. Jeff, you have a question?
Yeah, you mentioned that you're in the left midfielder position as well, right? Was it always that way, or you mentioned you also play defense, right? So did you have a hard time switching up before
positions? Okay.
Yep.
So I've always been a left midfielder, but then when UAP 81 happened, they placed me as a defense, but it was also like in the left side, so it was actually not that bad. But I really prefer offense. And for this UAAP, I was actually the striker, which was like, honestly, I ended up loving it. I ended up loving being a striker. So, but then COVID happened.
Oh.
Yeah, COVID happened. So everything changed.
Let's talk a little bit about your recruitment with Ateneo. Can you tell us a little bit about how that whole thing happened and what transpired in the background? How you came to Ateneo?
All right. So, well, the whole time in Ateneo de Cebu, I've been training so much. Even at night times, I would be the only one training. Mm. And there are times where the men's team would just sit around. I would tell them, hey, can we do 1-on-1 just so that, you know, I can get that feel of like I can actually beat a guy. And then I think I got recruited because my coach told me that, hey, there's someone from the Ateneo that was looking for you. I think I was like second year. This person wants to scout you. And I was like, is this a joke? Like, this is actually real. And then, yeah, so that it happened. Coach Bob got me, and then now I'm in the Ateneo.
So from second year high school, Ateneo has had their eyes on you. Were there any other schools that came into the picture between then and when you signed with Ateneo that kind of, you know, as you got better, you know, playing the sport, right? You'd get more exposure. Your name would become bigger. Were there any other schools that came into the picture?
Well, I was thinking of like going to the US and just to try out for like Stanford University. I actually played in their training camp, but I think like when I was in the US, my heart has always been for Ateneo. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to finish Ateneo. I'm going to get back and we'll see what happens. And so I did. I came back and everything's just been really great.
Right. I'm going to get into the Ateneo experience real soon, but before I get into that, I'm interested to talk about the Stanford experience. How was that for you? How was that like, you know, competing overseas in America, foreign players and all that? How was that whole experience like for you?
Honestly, in the team, I was the only Filipino. So it was a little bit of like a culture shock because I was still new in the US and I didn't really understand some of them. And most of them were really tall. So like when we would like train, like it was easier for them to like just bump people, just like run really fast. Like for me, I feel like I have to like go the extra mile just so that I can also compete with them. But it was a really great experience because I think it just opened my mind more in a sense that, you know, if football can't happen that much here in the Philippines, there's definitely other futures internationally.
Right. So if you weren't set on Ateneo, you could have been playing in the US NCAA right now.
I mean, if God willing, if it would have happened. Yeah.
Right. Jeff, I think you had a question.
Yeah, Selena, when you moved to Ateneo, so it's in Manila and you're far away from your parents. How was the experience in the first few weeks there? How were you able to adjust?
I loved it. I loved the independent life. So when I was already in high school, like I think second year, I told them, hey, I'm leaving. And then I think at a young age, they're like, wait, what? You're leaving? I was like, yeah, I need to leave. I need to just be independent. I need to learn life. And I really need to do football, but not in Cebu since I've been doing it so much. I needed something new in my life. So I left and I went to Manila. And from there, they've been supporting naman.
I see. That's great. So yeah. How was it juggling your studies and football as well, especially during that first year?
I think in the rookie year, it's definitely the most toughest year, especially since I'm based in Cebu. So I needed to like have friends in Manila. I couldn't really speak that much Tagalog. Like I'd only get context clues. And so I think like later on, I started like adapting and I started getting more friends. And yeah, honestly, I miss Manila. Like if I had the chance to go back, I would definitely go back and fly back and play football.
Selena, if we did this interview in Tagalog, would you be able to cope?
Oh my gosh, Mike, don't even start because I'll speak to you in Bisaya. Promise. I'll speak to you in Bisaya and I'm going to get back at you.
Oh, for sure. No, we'll leave it as it is. We'll leave it as it is for now. So talk about your Ateneo football experience. How has it been like so far? You've been through... You're in your fourth year now. You've been through a few seasons. Talk to us a little bit about what it's been like.
Okay, so again, in freshman year, it was very tough. So thank God my teammates were there to help me naman and support me. I didn't realize when I would go into college, I would have like a love and hate relationship with football. I think a lot of us don't really talk about that. There are times where we do get tired from like our studies. And so like, I think we put that also in our training, but we also get tired. And well, I'm in psychology. So like, it's always important to be like mentally fit. Like it's not just about being physically fit. Cause if you're mentally like kind of unstable, but you're physically fit, I don't think it'll really work out. So I really have to train my mind every day that, you know what, this is going to be your life. So you have to just stick through it, be strong, don't give up because, you know, you're here for a reason. And along the way, my teammates have just been so great to me and just welcoming me. And from there, honestly, okay, when the coach would speak to me in Tagalog, I would just look at him like, I'd be like, coach, I don't understand. And he'd look at me like, oh my God, like he'd look at me, sige, fine, I'll translate it na lang in English. And then so over the years, I got to learn Tagalog words. I'm like, oh my God, thank God, at least my coach won't get mad anymore. So yeah, it's been really great, again, the experience.
Yeah, I think Dave has a question, but before you talked about, you know, you talked about mental health. And being fit mentally, right? I think that's an aspect that a lot of people don't really understand.
Yeah.
Athletes, because they look at athletes and they look at, you know, what athletes do on the field or on the court or whatever sport they're in, and they look at it as a physical game, right? Like, but you're talking about it from a mental standpoint, and I don't think a lot of people, I don't think they understand the toll.
They forget about that.
Yeah, exactly. How were you able to cope mentally? Like, what did you do to help you cope and to help you kind of stabilize yourself from a mental perspective in getting, you know, getting up every day, you know, practice, trainings, games, and all that?
Well, honestly, I think it's just that grit that I had. Like, even if there are times where I'd be so tired, I'd still have that grit to still continue and play. And I would talk to friends, you know, if there are, like, certain aspects where I feel I'm a bit sad or tired. So we're very open, Aman. We talk about it. I think that's one thing that we should do. Like, be open about it. Talk about your problem. And if you have a problem, you know, just talk about it rather than, like, bottling everything up. Because it really becomes... crazy. If you really bottle things up, I think you'll explode in the field. And I think just by that, talking with friends, hanging out, even sometimes taking a break. I think a lot of us athletes or people that are hardworking, it doesn't necessarily have to be sports. It could be a career, it could be a business, you name it. I think there are times where you need to take a break, you step back, because there's so many times where we say, no, I don't want to take a break. Because this is what I'm good at. I'm supposed to do this every day, 24/7. This is my passion. This is my love. But you really need to take a break so that you can cope and that you can just breathe for a while, just so that you're also mentally stable again. And so I think a little break would do really good. You know, just for mental health and physical, your physical health.
Yeah. It's good to always kind of refresh your mind a little bit and take some time off. Dave, you had a question.
Yeah, before I get into my questions, Selena, you mentioned the word grit a couple times already. I think if you haven't already gotten a copy of Angela Duckworth's Grit, that's the title of her book, I think you will love it. Talks about the importance of persistence and grit. Definitely something that is a must-have, I think, for athletes especially. My question for you, Selena, well, I have a multi-part question, but the first one is, talking about the first few, first few months you're in town, again, you were by yourself. How was it outside football? How was it outside the pitch? What were some of the bigger, challenges or bigger wins, so to speak, that you had those first couple of weeks when you got here?
Well, the challenge for me was definitely speaking in Tagalog and understanding Tagalog. Like, I really did have a hard time. So I'd really tell someone like, hey, I'm sorry, I don't understand Tagalog. Just so like, there's also respect. Because I think if I spoke in English right away, I think some people might be caught off guard. Like, for example, if I talk to like a salesman or like the janitor, stuff like that, I'd be like, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry, Kuya Ate. Like, I don't really understand. And so my friend would be like, oh, this is what she's saying, this is what he's saying. I was like, oh, okay, you know, just be respectful towards others. And yeah, again, my friends actually helped me. I guess my friends did help me to like go a lot, and like they introduced me to like different people, just so like I also have like a support system.
Great. How about your classes? Any adjustments or I guess surprises, so to speak, that you had the first couple of days or couple of weeks? What were some of those, you know, this is harder than I thought, or this is easier than I thought?
Yeah.
How did the first few months of classes go for you?
Honestly, I feel like it was so hard to walk to Blue Eagle Gym to Bellarmine. I feel like that was more work because I had like a backpack, I had like a gym bag. I was like, you know what? I'm an athlete, I can do this. So I wouldn't ride the e-jeep. I'd have to walk. I honestly would have to walk, and like I would brisk walk. And then there are times where my teacher's like, are you okay? And I'm like super sweating. I'm like, ma'am, I came from training, you know, just don't mind me. I'll just sit down here, I'll just listen to your topic. And then she'd just be like, okay. But stuff like that. I hated walking in Bellarmine. It was the hottest and just the longest walk. I would rather do like 10 laps in the blue field.
Right. Well, speaking of training, my next question is actually about training. I'm interested to find out, what did you do for cardio? You mentioned 10 laps. How did you do that? Like timed? How often were you made to run? Because obviously I used to play basketball, but conditioning in basketball I think is a little bit different than conditioning in football.
Yeah.
I think football is way more tiring. How does a typical, I guess, cardio training day look like for you?
So yeah, we do have we do this workout, like we do suicides, we jog in the field for like 20 minutes, we do some sprints, you know, just different dynamics of like how to strengthen like our muscles and just the right way to run. But like, honestly, I lost so much weight because of this whole cardio exercise.
How do you do suicides? Really, like, how do you do suicides though? Like end to end? Because yeah, I mean, in basketball, it's a shorter field, right? Wow, really?
Yeah, we do end to end. Yeah, which is really tiring. And then I see my teammates, like we're just all like out of breath. We're just like, oh my gosh, guys, we can do this, we can do this. But inside, we're like dying.
Bro, this is why I never played soccer, bro. Like, I stuck to basketball.
You just stuck to basketball?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No way I'm doing suicides in a soccer field, man. That's just crazy, man. Like,
with the heat?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, how were your, cardio training days? Like how early did it start? Or how late was it for... In the day, was it?
Honestly, it would start sometimes at like 6:30 a.m. Sometimes you're so sleepy, but you have to like switch on. So you really have to be like mentally ready for like anything that the coach will tell you, because they don't really tell us the plans like a day before. They usually tell us on that day, like, hey, we're going to do this, right, we're going to do that. And so again, you got to mentally switch up.
What about resistance training or weights? Did you have to hit the gym regularly? How was the adjustment from high school going to the UAAP?
Honestly, there was such a big adjustment. Like, I think with high school, it was just all like fun and games. But like coming into UAAP, it was very serious. You know, the sports industry, they really take this, I guess, like as a challenge. And like, yeah, they take it as a challenge and like as a very serious sport wherein, you know, this is your job. You have to do it. You have to complete it. You can't just back out. And yeah, just stuff like that. It's been actually big adjustment.
Right. Speaking of that, I guess my question for you, Selena, is you mentioned about the transition from high school to college and playing UAAP. What for you was your welcome to the UAAP moment?
Oh my gosh. I think when I got my jersey, like that was when I said, this is real. Like, this is it. Like, your dreams are happening slowly, but like it's progressing. So this is good. This is a good sign.
Mm. Well, what was that first game? What was that first game for you like? The first time that you got on the pitch to play in the first official UAAP game for you? Do you remember that moment? What was that moment for you like?
I think when I started hearing the drums, I was like, oh my gosh, this is what you see in the TV. Like, this doesn't usually happen to a lot of people, but this is like happening to me. So like, I was very excited, nervous, and just like a lot of emotions. But when I heard like the Ateneo babble when they were playing, I was like, this is it. This is for the Ateneo, all hearts out. Let's go. Let's get it.
That's it. That's it. And yeah. And you're in your fourth year now. Sorry, Jeff, you have a question. My bad. Go for it.
No worries. Okay. Selena, how was the experience? I mean, how was the performance of the team in the first years? Any memorable games that you had with the team for this one?
I think in my rookie year, we won Pampanga Cup. And so I think that time it was a very good start because most of us were rookies. And I guess we just really vibed a lot with the rookies since, you know, it was our first year. And so we needed each other. Yeah, we really needed each other because, you know, it's our first year in Ateneo, so we don't really know what was going to happen. So again, the support system from friends, from the rookie team was really great. And I guess the transition the following years, I think we've been coping up well naman. I just think, I think now we should really practice more, and I really can't wait to get back because I really can't handle this online Zoom training. It's so sad.
What was your most memorable game so far in UAAP?
My most memorable, probably the first game that I had this year with against FEU. Like, even if we lost, I felt like, you know, this is a good step. Even if we lost, we can still come up stronger. And I was the striker for this year, so I felt like there was just a lot of potential that me and my teammates could have done. But then again, COVID happened, and I think the bond with my team this year was really great. Like, it's a different bond. It's like we understand each other. Like, we're there for each other. And I hope for the following years, you know, it gets better. I hope we can really get back and just see each other and just play the sport that we love.
How many goals are you scoring this year, Selena, when you get back?
Let's stay humble. Let's stay humble.
Speaking of your UAAP career, how about some of the lows that you've experienced on the soccer field? Can you talk a little bit about that? Obviously, unfortunately, we don't get a lot of coverage for women's sports and women's soccer, but we'll get into that a little bit more later. But can you talk about some of the lows that you've experienced on the field over the time that you've spent at Ateneo?
Okay. I think sometimes when I like make mistakes, or maybe like when my teammate teammates would make mistakes. And so, like, there's just a lot of, like, shouting in the background, like, your teammates shouting at you, just stuff like that. So I think there are times where, you know, it gets to us naman, because, diba, we're only humans. We feel a lot of certain things, even if we can be, like, mentally strong and stuff like that. There are times where it does get into you. But then I think in the longer run, they're just trying to push us. Like, the seniors are trying to push us, which is really good, because I think this is just life. Like, you know, you get pushed, you just have to get back up. You just have to, like, comply. You just have to train. You just have to, like, do your job as a football athlete. So, yeah, I think just times where there could also be drama. Since we're a girls' team, there can be drama. But, you know, I just try to step away from that, because it's just not my, like, not my thing.
Right, right. So you're in your fourth year now. What are your, personally and for the team, what are your goals and what are your expectations whenever we resume playing again?
I think for, like, this year, I really want us to play, like, as a team, as one. Like, for example, like, if ever I lose the ball, somebody will be there to, like, help me. I guess just to be very united, in a sense that, you know, I can call you my sister, you know, just stuff like that. And I really hope coming UAAP will place at least third, second, or even first, God willing, and hoping that we'll all work out together and, you know, we'll just strive for the best.
Jeff?
Selena, you mentioned about team chemistry. What are the bonding moments that you had with your team? I mean, what are your usual bonding moments in order for you to strengthen that team chemistry?
Well, there are times where we go out. Actually, every year we have, like, team bonding where we go to the beach in Batangas and we just talk about, like, life. We play games. I guess stuff like that every year that we do, it's actually required. So it's really good to just, you know, be closer to my teammates. Or even just, like, a simple dinner, a simple talk, or a simple getaway party, you know, just stuff like that.
I see. Okay, you mentioned, Selena, about your life as a female athlete. I think my question here is more about coverage on UAAP, because I think right now, we still, not a lot of sports are covered in UAAP. Any thoughts on that one, on how women's football can further be promoted, or what would entice people more to watch, basically, women's
You know, honestly, we keep saying that, you know, the women's team here is not really supported that much. So I think what we have to do is we have to keep fighting. We really have to keep fighting, just like how the LGBT people fought. Like, hey, this is what I want. This is what I love. You know, support us. So I think what we have to do is we have to keep doing that and doing that until people recognize it's like, hey, women are actually as important as men. And we also need men to support us as well, not just women behind everything. We really need you guys to actually support us and say, hey, actually, women's football, women's volleyball team, women's basketball team is just as important as ours. And I think with that, we can have, like, people just uniting us one. It doesn't have to be always that women are submissive, men are alpha, you know, just stuff like that, just to help our women's society engage in that level as men.
All right. With regard to women empowerment, I think you're into that, right? Who are your major influences, or do you read up stuff on it? So I'm just curious. Yep.
Okay. Well, I really like Michelle Obama, actually. Like, she just speaks of, like, such, I don't know, she has this voice where she just talks really well about, like, how women can actually be very smart, how we can be very driven. And I don't know, she just has this way in, like, explaining women empowerment. Like, so it just, I don't know, it makes me feel passionate about being a woman and how I stand up as myself. Because I think we see women as, like, there are times where men can see women as very submissive. But I think now women are starting to, like, slowly, you know, say, what's up? I can also be the alpha in this relationship, or I can actually be the strong, independent woman. Doesn't necessarily always have to be, like, men always uprising in, like, certain events.
Well, from my experience, the woman is always the alpha anyway. So,
damn.
How do you see women empowerment in our country? I mean, what changes would you like to see in order to have a better society for women in our country these days?
I think just for us to be like respected, like if women or girls wear shorts, just for us to be respected in a way that, hey, you know, she's still appropriate. There's nothing about that, like no judgment. I think just stuff like that, that we women, we deserve. I think we honestly deserve that. Just respect from one another.
Yeah, and equality as well, right?
For sure, equality.
It's that whole mentality that I feel like the Filipino culture still has about
being, oh, here we go, here we go,
being a very patriarchal society. A lot of, I don't know, this is just me ranting now, but I think a lot of our thoughts are still, you know, a bit backwards in that sense. Hence, yeah, why you see people, you know, looking at a girl wearing shorts and be like, you know,
and there's victim shaming, yeah, as well.
Yeah, and the victim shaming and all that.
It's a bit catcalling, yeah, stuff like that.
Yeah. But in any case, before we go deeper into what I feel like is a whole different podcast altogether, we have a section here called Five Questions. Dave, do you want to take this?
Yeah, for sure, man. Yeah. So basically, this segment, Selena, is I guess as the name implies, we have five random questions here. Usually, not related to sports. But you get to choose one at a time. You get to pick a total of three. Which is your first pick, I guess, Selena?
Okay. I'll choose one.
All right. Why don't you read this out loud for us?
If you were stuck in an island, which three players, coaches, celebrities would you want to be with you and why? Okay, I'll choose three players. I'd choose my friend Ang. She's actually my buddy. The next one would be Bam and Bea. Only because like I think we just relate with each other so well and we just have like a fun dynamics. Yeah.
All right. What's your second pick?
Number four. If you can have dinner with any person in the world, who would you choose and why? Wow, that's a crazy question. Probably Cristiano Ronaldo. I'd definitely have dinner with him. I'll ask him all the tricks and stuff like that and how to like succeed in football, and I'll probably ask him to schedule a one-on-one training with me.
Must be nice. Yeah.
Yeah.
Should be good. All right, your third and final pick, Selena.
Number three. If you can change anything in the UAB, what would it be and why? Probably like in the female industry. Like, I think just more support with, like, sponsorship maybe, or, like, media coverage. Yeah, just stuff like that that can enhance, like, the women's football team or other sports. And, yeah, that's technically it.
All right. Thank you for that, Selena. I guess before we go to the conclusion of the show, Mike, Jeff, you have questions you wanted to ask?
I'm good for now, bro.
All right. So we talked a lot about, you know, your experience in Ateneo, Selena, your football career so far. Assuming we do this show, this interview 10 years from now, it's 2030. By that time, what would you say you would look back on? What would you have achieved in the past decade? What does the 2030 version of yourself look like?
To achieve, okay, probably to win UAP. Not only that, but to become like a better version of myself. And I hope like in the following years, I'll also have that grit towards my passion, my desires, and yeah, honestly, I get to see you guys next 30 years or whatever and have this again, but then in a Lolo and Lola version.
Oh, speaking of pursuing, well, I guess a better version of yourself. How do you see yourself as a, you know, as a football player? And there's so much, I guess, so much to say about opportunities for women in general. But how do you see opportunities after the UAP for a football player like yourself?
Well, definitely if I leave the country, if I go back to like the US, I'll try to find like a club there wherein I can fit in and maybe hopefully I can also get paid. I think this time I want to try just exploring my opportunities abroad because I've been stuck here in the Philippines for so long. So definitely something new, new achievements.
Yeah, there's much to be said about being stuck in the Philippines. But before we get into that, what inspires you, Selena? What keeps you going despite, you know, all of these challenges, all of the ups and downs of being an athlete, being a student? What keeps you going?
Honestly, I feel like because I'm not in a place where I feel like I can be and I can like potentially grow, I think that's the thing that's like always just pushing me like, hey, Sel, you can always do better. Keep going at it. And just, I don't know, there's just this grit. I keep talking about this grit. This grit is very important. So I think as an athlete, we always have to learn, even from the basics or from the get-go, we always have to learn specific skills, specific trainings. We always have to go back to our roots, remember where we're from, stay humble, always stay humble because you never know what's going to happen. And yeah, trust the process in your whole training and hard work.
I like that. I think it's very evident from the way you've talked tonight and from the way you discuss football and then your mentality, your thinking. It's that fire in the belly, I think, is very important. It's admirable, to say the least. Mike, Jeff, anything you want to say before we wrap things up?
Yeah, now before we go off air, Selena, I just want to thank you for joining us tonight. Thank you for sharing some of your thoughts, some of your stories, some of your insights with us. Thank you for the time. We really appreciate it, and we wish you nothing but the best in the upcoming UAAP season. We hope you get to score a lot of goals and get a lot of wins for Ateneo. And yeah, we hope to, you know, we look forward to seeing what you get up to.
And she's a badass scorer. You can just feel it. You can feel it through the screen.
Yeah.
I can feel it through the screen.
Yes, sir. That's a nice House of Drew hoodie, by the way. I was gonna mention something about that at the start, so that's a dope hoodie.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks again, Selena. Jeff, do you have anything else to add?
Yeah, I just want to say thank you very much, Selena, for attending, for being here with us. And you mentioned a lot of things that we learned in this pod. So thank you very much. We wish you the best. And
Before
can I say something?
Yeah, go for it.
Yeah.
Okay, I'd also like to thank you guys for, like, you know, giving your time. Like, I guess this is just such a genuine passion of you guys that, you know, you're trying to enter, especially in this COVID. So thank you, Mike. Thank you, Jeff. Thank you, Dave. Shout out to Jeff again for being so kind and messaging even with my multiple questions. So thank you, guys. I really hope to see you guys in the future.
For sure. You talk about passion. But, yeah, no, it's very important for us. We all played competitively at various points in our lives, and we think sports is important. It's critical to development, and you know, we enjoy talking to people like yourself who are as passionate, if not more, and very, very into the game. We enjoy meeting people like yourself, and yeah, hopefully after all the craziness is over, we can get some Patron shots.
I was like, is Dave drinking? Cheers.
Yeah, you should have gotten your drink.
That was Celina Fernand from the Ateneo Women's Football Squad. That's a wrap for this episode. Hope you all enjoyed that as much as we did. My name's Mike. On behalf of Dave and Jeff, this is Game Time. We'll catch you all next time. Peace.